fatigue is kicking my ass today. I have zero spoons and all of the forks. So let's talk about energy theories. As you can tell, I'm tired, but it's more than just tired. Every person on YouTube that has a chronic illness will at some point talk about the spoon theory. And I'm not gonna try and tell you mine's better, but I am gonna mention it. I suffer with chronic fatigue. I, to my knowledge, do not have chronic fatigue syndrome. I do not have ME, but I do struggle with chronic fatigue as a symptom. It's just I struggle with fatigue on a daily basis, not as part of its own syndrome, but something else probably going on. I feel like I've just given up with all of trying to pinpoint which bits come from where. I struggle. This is all I've done today. Please excuse any mess that you can or can't see behind me. But yeah. The spoon theory was put forward by Christina Mizrandina, I think. I liked her name, so I think most of it has stuck in my head. And I will put a link down in the description about her blog post, I think, about it. But to sum up, we use spoons as a metaphor for energy. I'm going to use candy canes because they are next to my head and I barely have to move. Let's pretend these are spoons. For example, in a day you have however many spoons this is. This is 7 spoons. Okay. 7 fake spoons. Brain work, please. So, to get up and get breakfast is a spoon. To go and sit at my desk and work for an hour, another spoon. To go out to the cats and look after them, 2 spoons. And that's all before lunchtime when I have 3 spoons left. And 2 of those will go to looking after kittens again. And then there's 1 spoon left to do something else. That's on possibly a normal day. Maybe a day where the fatigue is kind of there more than others. I think I do have more than 7 spoons. I have more than that on a regular day-to-day. But I guess 7 spoons is probably like a day where maybe I didn't sleep so well the night before, so I can still function and do some stuff, but less than normal. Today I think I woke up with 1/2 a spoon, completely. And then I had to go look after the cats, which was 2 spoons. And now I can barely move. It's physically fatigued, so my even just moving these candy canes around and holding onto them is taking way more of an effort than it should. And to move the rest of my body, everything just feels like lead, trying to move through more lead. I just don't, there is not much moving going on today. But I thought I would tell you about the energy theories, because I've mentioned spoons before. So I did a video about easy spoony meals that you can make and eat when you are feeling possibly like this. I'll put a link up there. But not everybody knows what the spoon theory is, so I've just explained that. But another theory that I like that works to describe energy for chronically ill people, and the spoon theory and the fork theory, they can both be used by people with physical chronic illnesses, mental illnesses, hearing loss as well. That's where this one comes particularly useful. Autism, ADHD, any sort of neurodivergence, physical divergence, disability, all of it. So the fork theory is that I use it a lot to describe overwhelm and the fatigue that comes from being overwhelmed compared to having no energy. So the fork theory is if you can cope with a certain amount of forks in your back. It's kind of painful, it's not ideal, but you can cope with it. But if one more fork goes into your back, you will completely lose it. And I find this theory to be useful when I have listening fatigue. So if I've been listening to people and lip reading people all day, I can't. Or if I'm at a party and everybody's talking at once, that can get quite overwhelming. So if there is one more fork, so if somebody starts yelling and it drowns out everybody else, that is the last fork in my back, and I don't do so well. There are lots more energy theories used by the chronic illness community, because not everybody likes the spoon theory, not everybody knows about the fork theory. I am sure there is a knife theory somewhere. Some other people use life points. Some people use battery percentages or bars of battery, like on phones. Any way that you can sort of relate to energy, but I know that the spoon theory caught on really well, and the fork theory caught on enough that I've heard about it. I don't know about general popularity, but I know what that is. It's very useful for anxiety, and as I've said, hearing loss, cool, brain just lost the end of that sentence, but it's they have different uses. So I use the spoon theory for more like fatigue stuff, and the fork theory for overwhelm. So if you're chronically ill, I would like to know what energy theory you use, if not the spoon theory. And if you use the spoon theory, also let me know too, down in the comments below. And while you're there, don't forget to like this video, because I feel like poop, and I know that editing this is going to be so much fun. And this felt like the best way to capture me talking about chronic fatigue. Didn't feel right to do it when I was bubbly. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button too. And then, because YouTube, ring that notification bell as well, so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Something about an intro. I just post on Saturdays, and then once a month I post another video. It could be anything. Who knows? God knows what it'll be this week. Oh, yes! That's a thing that I meant to say. It's coming up to the Ouch Mouse channel birthday. February 9th was my first YouTube video, so let's take that as the channel birthday. For this month's bonus video, I want to do a Q&A. So if you have any questions at all, put them in the comments below. It doesn't have to be about chronic illness. It doesn't have to be about cold urticaria, hearing loss, gay stuff. It can be anything you've ever wanted to know. And I shall answer them. Maybe it will be a live stream. That's why you should click that bell so you... No, I don't know. All of my social media links are down in the description below, as well as a link to Ko-fi if you want to support me in any way financially. All of the links to that are down in the description below, always. And I will post on there if I decide to go live. I will try and give you a week's notice. I don't know where I'll be. It's my issue. I'm tired. I feel dead. So I'm going to go now, because I don't want editing Max to kill me. Anyway, do all that like and subscribe stuff, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!